On our Facebook page. And you can always expect the scams to ramp up around the holidays. Tonight, the Idaho Attorney General has a warning about pyramid schemes. They've been around for more than 100 years, but the way they are presented is always changing, and that's why people fall for them. Eyewitness News reporter Natalie Shaver shows us what to look for.
Oftentimes, pyramid schemes are presented in different ways or presented with slightly different packaging, if you will. And that makes them more alluring or helps, I guess, trick people or deceive them into thinking that they're not pyramid schemes.
Gifting circles are the new way these are being presented, and they're targeting women.
So it kind of plays off of the empathy that women might have or that they may have for each other, and gets them to a point to believe that if they invest a little bit of money, or they don't even term it as investments, though. They actually term it as a gift. And so they say, if you gift some money to this group, eventually the world will know you're a good person and you'll be paid back, you know, in many different ways.
And here's how these gifting circles work.
That you pay a fee, usually a few thousand dollars, sometimes $5,000, to be a part of this group. Now, once you're part of this group, the group promises you various things verbally, but in writing, they will not promise you anything.
Watching trusted friends and those who invited you to be a part of this can be enticing.
Because you've seen the quote-unquote success happen to those close to you.
It happens, though.
After time, the pyramid structure will break down. Because of the exponential growth that's required for pyramid schemes, they will eventually fail, and those at the bottom will always lose.
If you think you are part of a gifting circle, contact local authorities and the state attorney general's office. Remember, it's always best if it seems too good to be true, it probably is. Four Rexburg doctors have reached a settlement with Idaho Attorney General Lawrence Wasdin after they were investigated for refusing to provide on-call coverage at Madison Memorial.